Well, hello, you guys. Welcome to The Corner, where we talk about anime, manga, and everything in between. Are you guys ready to become heroes? Well, find your quirk, and let's get this review started for My Hero Academia. In this season of My Hero Academia, yes, I have to say season because there is going to be a season 2, and they announced at the very end of the season, which is something I rarely ever see. So I'm so glad that they announced there was going to be a second season, but now it makes me want to see it. I want to go further. I want to become more. My Hero Academia is pretty much something taken straight out of a Marvel or DC comic. I'd have to say Marvel more than DC because of the mutation that ends up happening with the human race. They call these mutations quirks. Quirks given to people and give them powers. Yes, it's just pretty much saying they have a superpower that they have obtained. When it really comes down to it, quirks are given to about 80% of the human population so far, so there is a little bit of an extinction thing for the old humans who are at 20%. But with our hero, actually, he doesn't have a quirk at all. But that doesn't stop him from wanting to be a hero and getting into the Hero Academy. This was a great origin story of how he becomes the greatest hero of all time. Before you guys say, spoiler, come on, that's not a spoiler. It's explained, in the very first episode of this season. I've always wondered what a comic book hero would look like in an anime, and I finally got my wish because I finally get to see this season, and I love it till the very end. Pretty much our hero meets his idol, and his idol tells him he can't be a hero because he doesn't have a quirk, because there's villains out there that you need a quirk in order to defeat. But what do you know, he shows himself as a true hero, and this hero has a quirk that can be passed down from generation to generation to generation. It's the only quirk of its kind, well, as far as they've said. My feeling is there's probably a villain with the same type of quirk that can be passed down from generation to generation as time goes on myself. But we get to see this hero grow into his own and do what he needs to do, even if it comes at the cost of a few broken bones. I'm really enjoying watching this hero grow up because he obviously has no control over his power that he just got, and he still needs to build his body up for the power in general, learning how to control the power flow of what he's actually doing, which is kind of an augmentation of his body, making it more powerful, stronger, and pushing even harder. And plus, All Might is on his deathbed pretty much for his superpowers. He really is going down and down and down. And the reason All Might chooses him is because of the fact that he showed to be a true hero at Spirit, and it inspired him to do the best he could possibly do. This kid who had no powers came in and tried saving someone on his own volition. He couldn't even do anything about it. His leg just moved. My Hero Academia has to be one of the best animes I've seen depicting superpowers and the growth of superhumans. Yes, there's the X-Men, but that's a comic book, and they don't really do much with that. They did a continuity series on it, but it wasn't really as good. Like, these mutants, for Xavier, ends up knowing how to really control the powers to a good point, and some of them could even do it even better. But this one is more depicted as a hero aspect, as in, they're not working a part of a giant team. They're trying to find out, kind of like the Incredibles, how to become better heroes. I honestly like animes like this, just because of the fact that you get to see the growth, and you get to see somebody go from nothing to something after a while through hard work and determination. And one of the other ones that is not an anime that or a comic book that this kind of reminds me of, if you guys are old enough to know this, but Sky High. Sky High did about the same type of situation where a hero with no powers gains powers going to a superior school from because they are a second generation superhero, or was it third? No, I think he was actually a fourth generation superhero. So I think they got a little bit of inspiration from Sky High on this one because he's a fourth generation superhero who did not get superpowers. I can make all the connections to this anime with other superhero movies or comic book stuff, but to be honest with you, they did a great job of making this their own. A good superhero action type of growth type of situation for a hero in general. I enjoyed it. I loved it, and I want to see more, and I can't wait for that second season that was announced at the end of the whole season one. There's a lot in this anime that just makes you choke up a little bit or get to a certain point, because I'm sure a lot of us have felt helpless, and I'm sure a lot of us have been to that point where we wish we could do better than what we're doing already, and this kind of drives that nail pretty hard. But anyways, you guys, I think I've talked to you guys off long enough about My Hero Academia, but I did enjoy and loved it, and that's the only reason I keep doing it. So until next time, you guys, I hope you guys have a great day and a fun one as well. Season 2, episode by episode review of My Hero Academia, coming soon.